everyone, I'm Milk.
And I'm Elliot.
This is the Trophée
Regional
International Coshtume Competition, where we will be kissing
or crying
the looks from the main stage of
the Grand Prix series
of figure skating. What do you have to say, Barbara?
Welcome to the show.
Welcome to the show. I didn't know
you were into skating. So, next event in the Grand Prix series brings us to British Columbia, Canada, a staple in the Grand Prix series, not one of those wishy-washy events that changes names from time to time. Skate Canada.
It's been here, it will always be here. Let's get into it.
Ooh.
First up at Skate Canada, we have the winner, congratulations, of Skate Canada, Alexandra Trusova, or as we, her friends know her as
Sasha.
Girl, she's just Sasha.
Junior world champion, much anticipated how she's gonna handle the senior Grand Prix. Turns out she's doing just fine, sweet.
This is a girl with quads.
Quads on quads on quads.
Quads, and for you non-figure skating watchers that are watching this, thank you.
Thank you for watching. Welcome. The frequency of the quads is truly new, and the Russians are really bringing that in full force. To have four quads in one ladies' long program is remarkable to me. It still doesn't even, like, I don't know that I fully comprehend that. It's not something I thought I would see. Sarah Hughes winning the Olympics with two triple-triples of questionable rotation. To do four quads in a program is incredible. Not even to speak on her age. It's what she's already accomplished in her short skating career is remarkable. But we're getting into the look.
She is skating to Peter Gint?
Right, Gint. In the Hall of the Mountain King. Mm-hmm. Music that I don't know that I've heard skated to, and I thought it was a really smart choice. They have made some smart choices for her in the past. They've had her skate to Kill Bill. It should be an obvious theme and something that maybe can cover up some things that she's lacking. I think that this program really does that successfully.
With that idea of them picking music with major themes, they often go with the costuming to help give the artistic interpretation. At Skate America, we had Anna Schirmer-Berver with her amazing costume reveal that really
Top look from Skate America.
Part of the Atari camp. They were like, okay, well, let's give another one a costume reveal.
You get a costume reveal.
But do you think they chose to give a worse costume reveal?
Yes.
Because it's not a successful, like gasp.
I didn't gasp this time. And I will say why I didn't gasp. I saw her standing there with her hand on the clasp for a couple seconds. I knew what was coming.
Then she revealed into like a bland gray number.
Right, it was like the gray white ombre dress into just the somber gray dress. You have to be wowed by the dress that you're revealed to. I do kind of like the gloves. As far as Russian ladies' gloves go, where they really all feel, I think, quite reliant on them, these are kind of nice.
Yes. The look is, I'm crying about it.
I think I'm gonna cry for this one. I'm honestly more gaggy for the music than I am for the look.
Yes.
And you don't want that.
And you don't want that.
Not when you have a quad in your arsenal.
But girl, she won.
Spoiler alert, she's probably gonna win again. And so I would like you to win us over with your looks at your next event.
Sasha.
Next up, in the ladies' field, we have Rika Kahira of Japan, another rising star from a country with a lot of depth. I think it was a miss for her not to make the world's podium last year. She has a lot to prove this year. She's skating to, I guess it's just like a Middle Eastern theme generally, which kind of is a big trend this year. What do you think of the dress?
The color is gorgeous. Mm-hmm. The color is really pretty.
Teal, are we calling it?
I'd say
peacock.
Ooh, peacock. I really like the color.
Mm-hmm. I think it might be that the gold appliques at the center is too wide.
It's heavy.
It's making her look too bejeweled, which is hard for me to say because I want to slather these dresses with more stones as a general rule.
I like the shape of the skirt, but I think it's a little too long.
Yeah, also too heavy.
I want shorter skirts. Mm-hmm. I also feel there's a new thing. They're trying to go longer with the skirts.
I think that might be an answer to a lot of people kind of like, if like a fashion dress has like a really short skirt, somebody will say like, it looks like a skating dress in a negative way. And I think that maybe skating people don't necessarily like that, that fashion people think of skating dresses as being this like niche separate from fashion thing. And I think this is them trying to blend fashion into skating that is not so separate.
Interesting. I love that.
Right.
But I don't love how long it is.
Right. I don't agree. Too much applique, too much skirt. Do we need to put some gold up in the hair with the big long ponytail that goes to the middle of her back? Maybe not. We are gonna give you some props though for the white boots. I think anytime that that happens, we need to really take note of that.
Yes.
And she's doing that.
Yes. So the boots look clean from what
Maybe.
I can see.
Yeah, they are not covered by boot cutters. Right? I'm gonna hold her to a high standard and I'm gonna shed a tear for her. I'm gonna give this a cry. I'm crying for this one.
I'm gonna cry about this one as well.
Up next, we have Young Yu from Korea. Rising star from Korea. Triple axles abound. Snags the bronze here. We're looking at her
short program, Romeo and Juliet.
Classique.
I love.
Beautiful.
I think the coloring
What are we calling the color?
Is it like a grayish lavender?
Lavender. The word that keeps coming to my mind that probably isn't right, but Weimariner? It feels very luxe.
I really love the styling when it comes to the hair. It works very, very well with this look. I really dig it. And a girl with a triple axle in a gorgeous costume like this gets a total kiss.
Kiss.
Kisses for Young Yu.
For you. Silly though.
Okay.
But like, right?
Next on the ice, we have Evgenia
Medvedeva.
This is her short program. She is in a bodysuit.
With wings.
With wings. I have to say, when there's anything wing-like attached to a skating costume, I'm immediately drawn to it. Gives me that, like, Fantasia vibe.
Ooh.
Sort of that ethereal... ethereal fairy.
Okay, totally.
Tell me your thoughts.
Right. To build off of your wings comment, I have been known to compete in wings. And I portrayed a bird with full set of wings and a full picture of a bird.
What type of bird?
Of paradise.
But that's not a bird. That's just...
That's a family of birds. The birds of paradise.
I thought that was a flower.
No. It's a flower also, the orange.
Yeah.
The birds of paradise are the birds that have like the crazy like mating dances and they make their like front yards all pretty for their loved ones. The birds of paradise.
Their front yards?
Yeah, you
wow,
see?
Wow, they even have a
Planet
front yard?
David Attenborough? Pull up the tape. But I do love a wing too, and this is a subtle wing. I think that might be maybe one of the more successful parts of this costume. I'm also really into bodysuits on somebody who's as limmy as her. We've seen Carolina Costner wear full bodysuits in the past and they have taken my breath away. Truly stunning. It's something about this, it doesn't work for me. Thinking about what made the Carolina Costner bodysuit so successful was that they were very streamlined. It was just one color with a buttload of stones and some straps, and it was very simple in design with the bodysuit. This is so Russian skating costume style with the like kind of just like shredded stones and colors thing happening in the front that it just reads not special or something.
Right.
I think that this music is really good. Ashley Wagner, Jeremy Abbott have skated to this before. Thinking about what Ashley's dress was, and that was more successful than this. This is not my fave muse look. I'm gonna shed some tears for this one. I'm crying.
I don't know.
Kiss her if you want to kiss her. But I'm gay. I'm going to cry for this one.
I'll kiss this. I like it. I initially really enjoyed it, and so I still enjoy it. A kiss and a cry. Lila Fear. That's such a fierce name.
Lila Fear?
Yeah.
Wow. That's great.
Ooh.
Right in front of the judges! That whole sequence was pretty cute. I kind of lived for that.
Next up, we're veering away from the ladies a little bit.
To the ice dance.
To the ice dance.
Your world.
My world. Lila Fear and Lewis Gibson. That name,
Lila
Fear.
What's up with the name? Lila Fear.
That's the name of a star.
Wow.
They are skating to a classic.
Classic.
Madonna. Vogue, honey, if you haven't heard of it.
Have we seen this on the ice before in competition?
I don't know.
I haven't, but maybe there's like some dance team that's done it.
Yeah.
But I'm here for it.
Yes.
It's really a great choice.
It's a good choice of music. There are some good parts of the performance. There are some parts that are a little like, okay.
A little more on the nose.
To do that.
There's some like photography flash noises.
I don't understand his look.
Yeah. To me, it feels like they came up with her dress and then they made the boy version for
and
him.
And it looks like they just like slapped an applique.
I also think the mesh on his is actually kind of nice. I think the mesh on the sides is something we've seen before. Like Adam Rippon has done this before. And I think maybe hers needed some mesh. Like maybe
Ooh.
Did she need black mesh arms or something?
This is sort of an extreme theme for ice dancing, for skating in general.
But I actually can even see Madonna in my head with the ponytail. I think the look needed to be more inspired by the ponytail.
So are you crying or kissing?
I'm gonna kiss it just because living for her name, living for his commitment to the number. I don't know anything about Lewis, but he's really serving me the Madonna down.
How do you feel?
She's really feeling it, the both of them, and for that, I'm gonna kiss them both.
Yeah, we'll kiss
Double
them
kiss.
Both. Mwah. That profile is gorgeous.
Uh-huh.
That nose is so pretty.
Really pretty.
We are moving to Piper Gillis and Paul Poirier. Rhythm dance to Mac and Mabel. Tell me your thoughts. I feel you have thoughts.
I have lots of thoughts. Many thoughts. Right off the bat, love it. I'm always into this kind of Victoria-y kind of thing. The color story, I'm really responding well to. There's pops of like the silvery gray. There is this magenta pink pop that I will also point out Piper is putting on her eye as well.
I know. I love
The just that they've really made a successful boy-girl costume where it's the same jacket on the both of them, and I love that it looks really, really good on both of them, and it reads girly on her, and it reads boy on him, but it also reads boy on her, and it reads girly on him.
Yeah.
I think that's really successful and cool. And it's very, like, on the nose, but in a somebody-has-to-do-it kind of way.
So cute!
Really
cutesy! So cute.
I think this is cutesy. I think it's really successful.
He's so cute. I give it a big kiss.
Double kiss. Well, that's a close from Skate Canada in BC.
Bye-bye, British Columbia.
BC.
Next up, we are off to Grenoble, France, for the International de France.
Ooh.
I am excited to see some looks, hon.
As always.
You can follow me and find me at Big and Milky on Instagram, and
I'm Eliot Halverson at Instagram. With one L. Yeah. If there are any looks from the Grand Prix series that you want us to review, send it our way with the hashtag TRICC. TRICC, and that stands for
the Trophée
Regional
International
Coshtume Competition. See you.
Bye.
Yes. Right. And let's just remind me what the music is. Gathering my thoughts.
Ooh, she was really
happy
with it though.